PI-AF Security gives PI administrators the power to configure access rights to the PI-AF server based on Active Directory, users, and groups. In the release of the PI-AF Server 2015, we can now map our Active Directory users and groups to AF identities. This makes the security configuration process much faster and more intuitive. In this video, I'll be creating and mapping customized AF identities and configuring them to have specific AF security permissions using the PI-AF Server 2015. Here we see PaperCo's AF database that already has some content. However, all of the security settings have been left to the default from a fresh installation. Let's inspect how our Active Directory users and groups are being mapped to AF identities. Clicking File, Server Properties, and then under the Identities tab, we can see that there are three AF identities by default. Administrators has full access to everything on the AF server, and double-clicking on it and moving to the Mappings tab, we can see that anyone who is a local administrator is mapped to this identity by default. This mapping is currently responsible for giving me administrative rights. Second is engineers. This account is almost as powerful as administrators, but lacks some administrative privileges. Clicking its mapping tab, we see that no one is mapped to engineers by default. Finally, there's the world identity. An important security consideration is that world can see everything on the AF server by default. We can see here that everyone that connects to the AF server is mapped to world, and this is something you have to consider when you're designing your AF security scheme. Defaults are a good place to start, but they don't always match our needs. PaperCo wants to take their Active Directory users and groups and apply AF security based on these users' domain credentials. I'm going to use this table to explain how we might satisfy their security needs using AF identities. Now, PaperCo has an administrator group that is local administrator on all domain machines. This group is going to need full access to maintain the AF server. The PaperCo Active Directory group proc engineers will need full access to everything related to their manufacturing process, but it's not appropriate for anyone in this group to see corporate finance AF structure. PaperCo's management team will need full vision into everything that's going on in the AF server, including corporate finance, but won't actually make changes themselves. Finally, there's the PI Corset application service that needs read access to the AF server in order to display the content on a web browser. But again, we want to protect the corporate finance AF structure from being displayed there. We saw earlier that anyone who's a local administrator to the AF server will be mapped to the AF administrator identity and receive full access to the AF server, so we can leave the administrator account alone. However, the world identity will show the corporate finance AF structure to every user that connects by default, so we have to change this setting by removing its ability to see that part of the AF structure. After we remove world's ability to see corporate finance AF structure, there will no longer be an identity that satisfies the management team's needs, so we'll have to create and map a new identity for them. Process engineering will need its own identity as well. Now, the world identity will satisfy PI Corset application needs once we remove its ability to see the corporate finance AF structure. Additionally, because everyone is mapped to world by default, we won't have to map the PI Corset application directly. I'm going to start to change the default security settings by first creating all of the AF identities I'm going to need. I'll right-click in the Identities tab of my Server Properties window and click New Identity. Then create my Process Engineer's identity, and over in its Mapping tab, we can add the mapping that will apply it to our PaperCo Active Directory group. That group is called Proc Engineering, and we'll click OK, and here we can see that the mapping was successfully created. We'll do the same thing for managers, except for instead of mapping it to Proc Engineering, the Active Directory we're going to use is called Management. I'll click OK and see that the mapping was successfully created. Now that we've created and mapped our new AF identities, we have to give them the appropriate permissions to satisfy PaperCo's security requirements. We can configure security settings for each AF object, like our elements and our event frames individually, but it's much faster to change them all collectively. And now, in PyAF 2015, we can use our identities to make those collective changes. One way to do this is to open the database menu, right-click on PaperCo's production database, and pull up this database security configuration. The way the security configuration window works is like this. Up here are the security collection items. For example, this elements collection item represents all current AF objects that are considered elements, as well as any new elements that we might create in the future. The items that you have checked here will receive changes to their security settings based on the identities that you have selected here and the permission boxes that you have checked here. Finally, you can choose to not modify lower level child permissions, update child permissions only for identities that you've modified, or completely replace all child permissions for all identities when you apply your changes. Let's start changing the security configuration here to accommodate PaperCo's requirements by adding the process engineer's identity. We need to give process engineers the ability to view and change all AF objects that are related to their engineering process. The object collections process engineers needs access to are the top-level database item, analyses, analyses templates, elements, element templates, and event frames. So I'll uncheck any item that they don't need. And uncheck any permission that isn't read, write, read data, or write data. Now, if you're not sure why it was important that I included read data and write data, these options and other AF security features are well documented and easily accessible using our PyLive library. This particular topic will be listed under PyAF access rights. I'll now choose to update all child permissions only for my modified identity and apply my changes. I'll repeat a similar process for managers by adding them and making sure that they have read and read data permissions for all of the same object collections that process engineers was given rights to. And again, I'll select update child permissions only for the modified identity. So now that I've applied the management changes, we're done with the database security configuration menu. And back in this menu, I'll point out that you can make changes on the server level instead by clicking this Edit Security button. You'll get a similar window with the same object collections, but you'll also be able to make changes to server-wide objects like identities, mappings, and contacts. Anything that you change there will affect any object on the entire server, which is why I chose to only make database changes just now. So after applying our database level changes, we've given process engineers full control of process-related objects, and we've given managers full read access to the AF structure. But we still need to remove process engineers and worlds read access to the corporate finance AF structure. Right-clicking on the corporate finance element lets us make security changes to the specific element. This window functions exactly like the one we saw when configuring database security, except that our changes will only be applied to the corporate finance element, and possibly its children, depending on which option is checked down here. I'll select the world identity and strip all of its rights, and select process managers and strip it of all its rights as well. I'll also elect to update the child permissions for my two modified identities, and now, after clicking Apply, they will vanish from the identities list, indicating that they no longer have any permissions to the selected item. Removing the rights to corporate finance that our process engineers and world identity had was the last step in satisfying PaperCo's AF security requirements, so let's log in as a few different users and make sure that our security changes have the impact we want them to. I've jumped to a user named Taylor's Machine, and Taylor is part of the PaperCo Proc Engineering Active Directory group. So let's make sure that they can read and write to everything that they need to, but also verify that they can't see the corporate finance structure. So right-clicking and connecting to our AF server, we can see that we've awarded the process engineer's AF identity, as well as the world identity, so we can tell that our new mappings are working just fine. Expanding the PaperCo root element, the first thing we'll notice is that the corporate finance element is hidden. Since Taylor has both the process engineers and the world identity, we can confirm that we've successfully hidden the corporate finance element from both of these identities. Now, let's say that a new paper press has come online, and Taylor needs to add it in the AF server in order to monitor its operation. We can see that Taylor's able to navigate into the manufacturing tree and expand the paper presses element. Right-clicking on paper presses, we can see that the element modifying actions like convert, checkout, and rename are available to us. So let's continue on and add a new child element to the paper presses tree using the paper press template. Now let's rename it to coincide with the naming scheme that the process engineers are already using. After renaming the element and inspecting the attributes tab to ensure that Taylor can see all the data associated with their process, let's say that Taylor notices that the template was configured wrong and that the basis weight for paper presses is actually being measured in kilograms, not tons. They would go into the library, expand templates, and inspect the attributes tab for paper presses and confirm that basis weight is indeed set to tons, not kilograms. Now we can go over to the default unit of measurement and change it from ton to kilogram. I'm going to click check in and check in all the changes that we've made. And since this succeeds, we can confirm that Taylor has all of the permissions they need to perform their role as a PaperCo process engineer. I've now switched to Madison's machine. And Madison is in the PaperCo Active Directory group called Management. The first thing we notice when we connect to the AF server is that Madison is indeed granted the manager's AF identity as well as world. And expanding our PaperCo root element, we can immediately tell that Madison is able to see the corporate finance AF structure as well as the manufacturing structure that the process engineers are maintaining, including the newly created Press 9 and its attributes. This time, when I right-click on Paper Presses as Madison, we can tell that managers have significantly fewer options than our process engineers do. Specifically, there's the notable absence of anything that lets Madison change or add to the asset framework, like the delete or the rename button. This should make sense because we haven't given the world or the manager's identity any permission to alter our AF structure. And so now that we've tested our new AF identity permissions and mappings, we can be confident that the security scheme that we set out, designed, and built meets PaperCo's specific security needs.